A little while ago, I wanted to ensure that my tailstock was aligned with the center of my lathe chuck. I mounted a steel bar between two centers. But I did not want to set up a dial indicator with a magnetic base mount. For this application, I find them awkward, bulky, and not very rigid. I decided to make my own indicator mount that would be easier to set up, more rigid, easy to adjust, easy to build, and inexpensive. It should also be compact and fit neatly in a drawer when it's not being used. In this video, I will show you step by step how I made a simple and reliable dial indicator mount that will work on any lathe. Let's get started. My dial indicator mount has only two parts, a tool post holder and a piece of flat stock. The dial indicator needs to be a lug mount type. I have an older, high-quality Mitutoyo dial indicator that was donated to me in very rough condition, and a newer, less expensive dial indicator. Inexpensive dial indicators can be bought at Harbor Freight in the U.S. and other places such as Princess Auto in Canada. I will put a link to both in the description below. I am not sponsored or receive compensation from either company. Both of my dial indicators are accurate up to 1/1000th of an inch. I decide to use the older Mitutoyo for this project. It doesn't look so good, but it works good. That reminds me of an old joke about a farmer that bought a blind horse. The farmer realizes that the horse is blind and goes back to the seller and says, "You never told me the horse was blind." "That's not true," said the seller. "I told you that the horse doesn't look so good, but he is good and strong." I measured the tool gap in my tool holder. It is 51/1000th of an inch. I rummaged through my collection of metal and chose a piece of 1/2 inch aluminum flat stock. It doesn't look so good, but it works good. The aluminum stock is 1¼ by 1½ inches long. The tap and drill chart calls for a number 21 drill. The closest I have is a 4mm drill, which has a diameter of 0.57 inches. I drilled the hole along the long edge of the flat stock, 7/16 of an inch from one end and 1/4 inch from the top or bottom of the workpiece. Afterwards, I tapped the hole with a 1032 tap. My tool holder has a 1032 screw. It has a knurled nut and it is long enough to secure the lug mount. I had to measure with a micrometer to convince myself that it was a 1032 machine thread, not an M5x8 thread. The M5x8 machine thread has a similar outside diameter, thread pitch, and depth of thread. The two threads are so close that either one will work for this dial indicator mount. The M5 screw will screw easily into a 1032 tapped hole and vice versa. Plan B, which is more foolproof, is to drill and tap a 1032 thread and use a 1032 machine screw long enough to attach the dial indicator to the workpiece and vice versa. Drill and tap an M5x8 thread and use an M5 machine screw. To secure the lug mount using a 1032 screw, I made a simple 1/4 inch bushing that I drilled with a 1364-inch drill to allow clearance for a 1032 machine screw. After drilling and tapping the hole, I screwed the height adjustment screw into the workpiece until it was snug against the bottom of the hole. I slipped the bushing over the screw, then I gently placed a dial indicator over the screw and bushing, securing the dial indicator snugly with a flat washer, lock washer, and knurled nut. Some inexpensive dial indicators like mine have a diamond-shaped protrusion on one side of the lug. This helps to hold a dial indicator snug on a magnetic base mount. The flat washer and lock washer press against this protrusion. For my new mount, the protrusion is on the wrong side of the lug. It presses awkwardly against a workpiece, preventing the lug from seating flat against the workpiece. A 1/16-inch solid rubber washer between the lug and the workpiece will allow the dial indicator to seat flat and snugly onto the workpiece. This was the first dial indicator mount that I made. It is very simple and it worked fine, but it positioned the dial indicator somewhat above the lathe center. I was able to overcome this by loosening the knurled nut and tilting the dial indicator down until the tip was pointing directly towards the lathe center. I could have lived with it, but I decided to make a better looking mount, one that would lower the height of the dial indicator enough to point directly at the lathe center without tilting the dial indicator. I used a flat bar slightly less than 3/4 of an inch. It measured 700 thou thick by 1.5 inches wide by 2 1/8 inches long. This piece was perfect for my 2-inch long tool post holder. I cut a slot along the length of the workpiece to allow a 1/2 inch high by 300 thou deep shoulder. This is to fasten the workpiece to my tool post holder, lower than before. I put the workpiece into the tool holder and scribed the line flush with the bottom of the tool post holder. This is kind of important. If the workpiece rests lower than the tool post holder, the compound slide would interfere with the height of the dial indicator mount when it is attached to the tool post. I milled the waste from the bottom of the workpiece. Then I deburred all the sharp edges. Next, I scribed a vertical line halfway from either end of the workpiece. Then placed a dial indicator flat on top of the workpiece. A radius on the dial indicator's lug prevented the indicator from laying flat. Using a file, I chamfered the workpiece to allow the dial indicator to lay flat. I positioned the indicator so the lug hole was centered on my vertical line. Then I marked the vertical height of the hole with a 1/4 inch round center punch, tapping lightly to prevent any damage to the dial indicator. I drilled and tapped a 1032 hole, then attached the dial indicator to the workpiece. I placed the workpiece into the tool holder and snugged up the 4 set screws. When I attached the mount to my tool post, the dial indicator tip was aligned with the center of my lathe chuck. FYI, the dial indicator mount sits flush on top of the compound slide. There is no need for a height screw. Now that it's made, I really enjoy using the dial indicator mount. It looks good, and it works great for indicating work held in a 4-jaw chuck. For checking tailstock alignment, and for adjusting my compound slide to cut a taper. When I am finished with my indicator, I remove it from the tool post and store it gently in my drawer to protect my good old dial indicator from more damage. I hope you like this project and I have inspired you to make your own dial indicator mount. Let me know if you have any suggestions or know where I can get a new lens for my good old dial indicator. Don't forget to tap the like button and subscribe.
Bye for now, and